few gels, head back.
One of the toughest, hardest challenges I've ever done.
It's kicking in now. Smashing down gels just to stay awake.
So it's Friday the 24th. We've got 3 days until the ride.
So the 24 hour ride. So I don't think this could be a long old video. I've got a few, borrowing some GoPros off some friends. So I've got a couple of GoPros, so we're gonna have various angles from this with me on the bike, some on-bike stuff with a GoPro that'd be on, well, it'll be on Eleanor anyway. And then I think Jess gonna have some GoPro cameras and stuff. Pretty much packed. I just need to get some more boxes. Alice has now put back together. As long as that tyre stays up. Thanks to Rory for the wheel. Hopefully I won't need that bike. But I know what will happen if I don't take it. I need to quickly, because it is getting dark, I need to go and clean Eleanor, because she's Megan. Everything's on charge and charged. Just trying to think what I'm going to forget, because I'm going to forget something. Food is pretty much sorted. I've got rice boxes to make tomorrow. Styrkr are all over the bars, gels, car powder. Yeah, it's go time. Time to start loading up the car, which it's all kind of gone very quick. But yeah, this is going to be a tough one. It didn't really hit me until yesterday, so Thursday, of quite possibly what I've taken on this time with this. This is, I thought the Everesting was hard. This is, it's going to be a different one, because there's no, I have numbers in mind for how far I can go. But it's more about the time on the bike. Raising money for a great charity, and the distance is my own little personal achievement. But I've got a good group of guys leaving Exeter with me from the Cycle Sanctuary at Winslade. I've got some mates joining me along the way. Darren's going to join us. Hopefully, he done Land's End to join the Groats with me in April last year. Well, it ain't going to be April this year, is it? Because it's only bloody February. But yeah. Time to get loaded up, I guess, and chill out and get some sleep. And yeah, now just spend 3 days watching the rugby and working. And then Monday we are a go. But yeah, so time to get finished up, I guess. It's looking very empty in here. Currently in the process of sorting out my sofa as well. Get rid of that. So yeah, packing is started. Let's go get some more boxes. Just a few small ones. I like things to be in a place. So I like to be organised, but I like to. Also, I've only got one roof rack, so there is no spare bike on there. Let's get these lights on a minute. Yeah, there we go. So yeah, food, paperwork. This is everything's there pretty much. There we go, that's better. Yeah, spare bike's just crammed in there. Jerseys, helmet, kit. Just needs to go and get a few more boxes and then we're all set. Get some fuel. And then load up and we are good to go. As far north as possible. It's rugby day. and sat here pondering, and I don't like it. I've not ridden the bike, but I've ridden the bike for an hour this week. It's still my head in. I'm overthinking everything at the minute. It's just, the car's loaded, I just need to portion the food out. The bike's ready to go, Jess ready to go, the route's ready to go, the people at the start's ready to go, everything's ready. Just, I don't know, I'm just, normally any challenge that I sort of do, like even the job, and that was organised with six people, like everything, support card. We've got support card this time. It's just, everything builds up, and I just tell myself that one bit. Like, the Everesting was off the cuff, so I didn't really have time to think about it. Yeah, just need to get going. It's only Saturday, but all day tomorrow. Just sat here, pondering, thinking about, well, not nothing, just, well, nothing related. And it's just, I don't know, just sucks. I'd just rather do than get going, to be honest. Yeah. It's Sunday evening. My kitchen is very steamy because I'm cooking pasta. For now, not for tomorrow, because finally I think everything is settled and ready for tomorrow. Bike's got the addition of the GoPro from Corey. Happy days. Normal clothes are packed. Bottles are full of water. They'll get car powders in as and when needed, so they don't go lumpy and horrible. Food, I'll put a photo in because I forgot to film when I had it all laid out, so I'll put a photo out. But we've got some salmon and broccoli pasta salad in there, ham and leek pasta bay, some moussaka and devon potatoes, some proper food to, well, so it's not cycling food and nutrition stuff. Box of t-shirts from Shut Fellow. That's for the guys that come out and help support and ride. There's not a lot left to do other than get on the bike and ride. We're all meeting beforehand, having breakfast. Having breakfast at Wednesday before we head out, so that'd be quite nice just to chill out. And mentally, I don't feel ready, but it is what it is. The fundraiser's at £300 now, which is I'm stoked for. I think it was on like £160 last time I spoke to the charity on Friday, so that'll be a nice surprise for them tomorrow when they check up on it. So huge thank you to anyone that's donated. I'll leave a link in the description to this video. Obviously this video will be post-event, but the fundraising page I'm using is open all year for any other events. Although I am doing other events, but that's for another video. But yeah, so we're pretty much there, pretty much set. Just coming up in the morning. Car's all loaded. And yeah, just time to get on the bike now. So I guess the next time I see you will be tomorrow morning.
Oh, not a pleasant sight. However, it's ride day. It's early, was not. It's 7:15. Got an hour until Jeff gets it. Took the last bits in the car, get up and get motivated. Get this show on the road.
Should you work here?
Yeah. good time.
Yay. Off to meet Aiden and some of the Cycle Sanctuary gang. A few of us supporting Aiden on part of his 24-hour bike marathon, cycling marathon for the Exeter Leukaemia Fund. It's going to be fun. Just on my way to meet them now. What an absolutely stunning day. This. Not a cloud in the sky. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Keep going, hold on.
Have you got my long gloves?
Got long gloves, yep.
Good luck!
First update, because I've kind of just been head down. We're 3:30, so that's 10, 11, 12, 5.5 hours in, 130 kilometres. Fresh chamois at the bottom of Cheddar Gorge. Just trying to tone myself back, keep myself back, which is a lot more difficult. Anyone that knows me knows I'd rather just go out and absolutely smash myself, but we're not today, we're holding back. So let's go to Cheddar Gorge. So, we're a fair way in. Cheddar Gorge is done. And now, just heading over Chew Valley, past the lake. Here's the boys. Look at that for a view. Quick update. Sun setting. It's 6:20. The wind's finally died down. I've had like 56k just non-stop headwind. But I have no clue where I am. It's gonna be dinner time next time I see the car. But look at that for sunset. We keep plodding it on.
We were driving along.
I'm videoing.
I'm just going to go sit on this, the live chat.
Lovely.
Get in there, look at that mouthful.
Caught in a massive downpour going through Hell's Owen just before Dudley.
McDonald's, coffees,
kit change, shoe change.
Oh, lovely.
There's
extra sugar. Do you want sugar?
No, thank you.
Right.
Oh. Lovely. Let's crack on. Wolverhampton.
6 a.m. in McDonald's. Breakfast has filled a little bit. The idea of 500 kilometers is gone. The rain, the headwind from Birmingham onwards, just delayed, got lost in the back country, and then just hit a wall. So, just finish now. It's going to be in the 400s, time to finish.
It's kicking in now, smashing down gels, just to stay awake. Yeah, I don't even remember riding up that hill. Oh! Oh, this sucks. 3.5 hours. That's all that's left. I think. That's 6. So, yeah, 3.5 hours.
What have you made it?
402.
What was that? Look at the camera.
And
402. Well done, mate. Absolutely outstanding. Few gels, head back.
Ready pub.
Well done, mate.
Oh, my knees.
Well done.
Home, sweet home. Oh. Oh, what a ride. Hasn't quite sunk in, I don't think. It'll be tomorrow when I've got to sort all the bits out. But tonight, sitting on the So Fortune TV. So, yeah, that's a little insight into the 24-hour ride. I don't get a lot of footage because I was just concentrating on riding, to be honest, but it is what it is. Thanks for watching. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. and I'll see you on the next one.
So this is absolutely nuts, the amount of support before the ride, during the ride, and now after the ride. Big thanks to Jeff and David. I couldn't have done it without them driving the car. And thanks to everyone that has donated. The online fundraiser is at £330 now. It was at £170 before the event started, which is just crazy. And that's not including the donations that we received throughout yesterday and this morning, and donations from work and other stuff. So yeah, hopefully that means we're above the £500 mark, which is absolutely unreal, and all of that goes directly to Elf. So thank you to everyone that's supported.